I kept God completely out of the picture because I was busy having a good time, and I didn't really want, a relationship with God.
Having a good time was the motto of Matt Krueger's life growing up. His passion and ability to play sports opened the door to plenty of partying in high school and during his college years.
I played sports in college at a small school and had a lot of great friends, but we'd party a lot and we had a lot of fun. But, you know, I just at that point in time didn't really see a need for going to church a whole lot.
His partying came to a halt when, during a routine physical in college, 18-year-old Matt Krueger learned he had cholesterol levels over 400, which could lead to a severe case of CAD, coronary artery disease. It's a condition where plaque builds up inside the arteries feeding the heart.
The normal cholesterol level should be around 100 to 150. The nurses kept on coming back and they took my cholesterol reading three times because they couldn't believe it.
Because Matt was adopted as a baby, he didn't know the medical history of his family. But like most young men, Matt didn't think much about his condition and continued his wild lifestyle like nothing was wrong.
We drank a lot, and I think maybe one of my excuses was, well, life's short, so let's party. You know, I was young, I was in great shape, playing sports, I wasn't overweight, and so I just kind of shrugged it off.
Matt's longtime girlfriend, Marina, tried to convince him to be more conscious of his health, but Matt wasn't listening.
I could tell he felt like life was over, like that he might not have a future. So I guess I took on the role of feeling like I needed to reassure him that there was still going to be a future.
At 22, Matt had a heart scan. It revealed that so much plaque had built up in his arteries that doctors warned he could have a heart attack or stroke at any moment. They recommended immediate surgery. Matt began to get serious about his life.
And I remembered thinking to myself, you know what, maybe it's time to kind of move on with my life. And maybe it's time to stop partying and start to have a family.
Matt and Marina decided to marry. Finally, when Matt was 26, he agreed to have 6 stents inserted in his arteries to open up the blockages. It was actually during the surgery that he learned why he hadn't died already.
My heart had started to grow its own little tiny bypass in capillaries.
But Matt's surgery led to an unexpected side effect. For the first time, he really became fearful of his own death.
Any little ache and pain that I would have, I would immediately go to the thought of, oh my gosh, this is it. So much so that I even took 2 ambulance rides to the hospital only to find out there was nothing wrong with me.
Matt's fear of death began to wreak havoc on his marriage.
He really couldn't concentrate on anyone else. I mean, that was taking all of his mental time. I battled with feeling like you couldn't meet his expectations.
Matt's breaking point came after a day he spent doing yard work. He was sure he was having a heart attack and quickly began to pray.
I said, God, if this is it, if this is a heart attack, and I do die, then I want to make sure that I'm going to be with you. It was kind of at that point that I truly, with all my heart, asked Jesus into my life. I kind of held him off to the side for so many years, and it was my last hope and my last option, but it was my best option. A peace came over me, and now I almost felt like the devil can't torment me here, because if I am going to die, I'm going to go and be with God.
Matt didn't have a heart attack that day, but he says God gave him a new spiritual heart. That's when things really began to change. Marina was the first to notice.
He's selfless. He's got an amazing sense of discipline that you don't see in a lot of people. And he's got a heart for God and a heart for wanting to serve, which is just 110% opposite of who he used to be.
God did not give us a spirit of fear, but a spirit of power and of love and of self-discipline. When you let go of your life and you give it to God, he wants to show you how he's faithful.
Today, the Kruegers have 4 children, a successful business, and a strong marriage. Matt has changed his diet and exercises regularly. All of that has given him a much healthier heart and a much happier life.
Life is shorter than we think, and none of us want to think about death, but it will come to all of us. He just wants us going forward to continue to love him and to grow in him so that when we get to that judgment day, we've done what we can on this earth for him and we can spend the rest of eternity with him.